Okay, welcome to the screencast about the operation of manometers and hydrostatic head. And so the idea behind hydrostatic head is that if we have this column of fluid, then that mass of fluid accelerated by gravity will produce some force on whatever is sitting below here. And that force divided by the cross-sectional area here will be equal to a pressure. And so if we want to look at that formally, we have this equation on the right here, that the pressure is equal to the force exerted by that fluid divided by this area, which is the area of a circle, if it's a regular column of fluid. And so we can write this force as the density of fluid times the volume of fluid, which is the height of the cylinder times that area of the circle to make up the cylinder. And then we have the acceleration of gravity. And we optionally should probably go ahead and put in GC here in case we're dealing with English units. And then we can divide through by the area. Of course, the areas cancel. And so then we have this rho h times the gravimetric constant that you see in the textbook. And so again, this pressure is just caused by the weight of the fluid divided by the area. All right, and then potentially, if we just have vacuum above the fluid, so no additional pressure, right, then this is all of the pressure that's exerted at this point. But we could have some kind of atmospheric or other pressure, other fluid pressure, on top of this column fluid. And then we would just add that force divided by an area, which again would be a pressure, to our total pressure term associated with the column of fluid. And so now let's consider a manometer and how it works. It really just uses this principle. Right, and so again, the idea is that a height of fluid is somewhat equivalent to a pressure because we can relate that height of a fluid to a force exerted by that amount of fluid. Right, and so in a manometer, if we have both ends of the manometer tube exposed to atmosphere, then of course we expect the manometer fluid to equilibrate out at the same level. Right? The pressures here and here should be equal and should be equal to the atmospheric pressure. Right? But if now we take one end of the tube and hook it up to a gas source at another pressure, then if that source is at a higher pressure, then we expect it to push down on the fluid. So again, this is hooked up to a pressure P, and this is the atmospheric pressure. All right, so now if P is greater than the atmospheric pressure, then it's going to push down on the fluid and cause the fluid to rise up against the atmospheric pressure. And so the difference between atmospheric pressure and this pressure is equal to that height of fluid that was pushed up. And so in order to lift that weight of fluid, you had to have a force differential, or in other words, a pressure differential, between this source at pressure P and this atmospheric pressure. And so we can just write that P minus P atmosphere is equal to rho G H, where our H is here. And so that's how a manometer basically works. And then we can have added layers of complexity. And so as I mentioned, this is for both sources being in the gas phase. All right, but let's suppose that we had actually a liquid phase measurement that we were going to do. Okay, and so if we were going to do a liquid phase measurement, then we would actually have to worry about the height of fluid here as well, because that fluid could exert a force at this point. Right, and so in addition to the pressure that you're feeling up here at this point, you have this height of fluid that's adding to that pressure. And so that would help to push this down. And so we can write that as being that the pressure plus, we'll call this distance, I think it may be listed as D2 in the textbook. I'll go ahead and put that there. So that pressure plus rho G D2, and this is the density of the fluid in the tank or in the pipe that you're measuring. So this is the total force that's being exerted at that point. All right, is equal to the external atmospheric pressure on the other side of the manometer tube plus the extra weight of fluid that it's feeling at this point. So again, plus the rho GH, where this again is the density of the manometer fluid. And so again, the idea is that you should be able to draw a line straight across a manometer. And if the pressures were equal, then you would expect the level to be the same on both sides. So if the force being felt at both surfaces of the manometer fluid were the same, then of course the levels would be equal. And so the height of the manometer fluid, and thus the total volume of that liquid, and thus the total weight of that liquid, gives you a way of measuring the force difference between this point and this point.